attention like ladies and gents when I mention my name at the door. And I hope you'll pardon me, see by my card I am finding a world we may explore. You're in the dream I have drawn. You're like the wings for my song. I get a lift with your gift to know right from the wrong. Really strong. Our imagination will find this occasion to go where we know we belong.
It was Harold's bedtime. But Harold wasn't thinking about sleep. He was worried about his pet goldfish, Goldie. Harold's mother had told him that Goldie had died. Harold didn't understand what that meant. He'd never known anyone or anything that had died before. Harold wondered where his mother was taking Goldie, and when Goldie would be coming back. Harold decided that he wanted to play with Goldie now. Right now. For Goldie.
Oh.
But she wasn't anywhere. Then Harold remembered Goldie was a goldfish. So, if he wanted to find her, he'd have to look in a goldfish bowl. Harold felt light and free in the water. It was fun to swim like a fish, but Harold thought it would be more fun to do it with Goldie. Harold hoped he might find Goldie inside her castle. Surprisingly roomy. Harold thought he'd spotted Goldie, but it was only a shadow on the wall. Could that be Goldie? Harold wondered. Harold's eyes seemed to be playing tricks on him. But that wasn't going to stop him from finding his goldfish. Goldie wasn't inside her castle. Goldie wasn't outside her castle. Goldie didn't seem to be anywhere. There had to be some way to make Goldie come back, Harold thought. Maybe some new toys would do the trick. With all these treasures awaiting her, Goldie would come swimming back any moment now. Harold was sure of it. Harold was beginning to get the feeling that Goldie wasn't ever coming back, but he didn't understand why. Had he done something to upset her? Harold tried to remember if he'd ever done anything to hurt Goldie's feelings. Harold remembered a time when Goldie hadn't come when he called. Harold had been very angry with her then. Then there had been a time when Harold had wanted to play fetch. But Goldie wasn't interested. Harold had wished at that moment for a dog instead of a fish. A dog would play fetch with him. After all his remembering, Harold was sure that it was his fault Goldie went away.
Beside a window that's open to your soul, like life in a goldfish bowl. When I call you, there is no reply. Me here just hanging out to dry and fishing for an answer, wishing for a chance, and you'd let me know but one good reason why. Though you're out of sight, I remember that time, and there's something that you left behind. I gave you a piece of my mind. At least give some peace back in kind.
Harold hadn't meant to, but he'd awakened the sleeping mermaid. The mermaid noticed that Harold seemed sad, and she wanted to help. Harold told the mermaid that his goldfish had died and that it was his fault she wasn't coming back. The mermaid tried to explain that it wasn't that Goldie didn't want to come back. Goldie couldn't come back because Goldie was dead. That meant Goldie's body had stopped living and breathing and moving. The mermaid assured Harold that none of this was his fault. Even if he'd had a bad thought or two about Goldie, that wouldn't make her die. The mermaid wanted to help Harold understand Goldie's death a little better.
Thank you.
maid told Harold that death is a natural part of life, just like being born, or growing up, or learning how to dance. Had seen how older creatures teach younger creatures, passing on what they know. But he still didn't see what any of that had to do with Goldie. The mermaid had more to show Harold on land, but she was still half fish. The mermaid explained to Harold that what happened to Goldie happens to all living things. We are born. We grow. We live. We grow older. Until we die. Allowing life to begin again.
Life's such a hustle and bustle, it's true. And then, like a song comes to, you go search for life down in the sea. If you have a heart for mystery, this is where some life began, that went ashore and walked and ran and did it all according to a plan. We meet on a cycle of life, my dear friend, and it has no beginning or end. Begin to explore. Our love is forever and more. In the spring, just for water we got for the sea.
See,
that's all. Your life is the cycle of
Now Harold understood. Just like the leaves and the flowers and the frogs, it had been Goldie's time to die. And even though there'd be new leaves and flowers and frogs and goldfish, nothing he could say or do would bring his Goldie back. The mermaid reminded Harold that even though the Goldie he knew was gone forever, in many ways, Goldie was still with him. Harold didn't see how Goldie could be with him when she wasn't here anymore. The mermaid asked Harold to think about all the ways Goldie had touched his life, all the things he'd learned from her. These memories would live on in Harold, and he could pass them on to others. As Harold started to think about Goldie, he decided to draw pictures of the good times they'd had together to help him remember.
Now I know why she's not coming back. She left a ring for me. How do you do, and then goodbye. One, there's only one tear left to dry. I'll keep fishing for an answer, wishing for a chance that you'd share with me your daring, do or die. I now understand if you stay in my heart, some sweet sorrow says we'll never part. Your friendship is golden and bright. My love, just beholding your light.
Remembering Goldie in this way hadn't actually brought her back, but it had made Harold feel much better, and the mermaid told Harold that his drawings had helped her feel as if she had known Goldie too. Harold was getting sleepy. He was ready to go home. So was the mermaid. Still missed Goldie. He always would. But it was comforting to know that his memories of her would always be with him, just like the moon. There was one more thing Harold wanted to do before he went to sleep.
Goodbye, Goldie.
The purple crayon dropped to the floor, and Harold dropped off to sleep.